I'm Ida, a digital strategist here at GRM Digital. Today I'll be talking about headless CMS and how's it different to a traditional CMS. There's been a lot of confusion recently around what headless really is, so I'll try to explain it within a few sentences. Before we start, feel free to subscribe to our video channel or YouTube channel. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up or a like. And if you've got any questions, feel free to pop them in the comment section. So let's get started. We all know that multiple heads coupled together are way more efficient and productive than only one. So this is pretty much what headless CMS is all about, but probably the name, headless, does not support this claim. But let's wait till we hear more about it. Headless CMS is a new type of a content management system which is slowly dominating the market. We've seen it replacing traditional CMSs such as Sico, Kentico, Bracco, WordPress, and many others. It's more referred to as a software as a service, as in SaaS model, with the content being separated from its output. And in this case, it would be a website or a mobile app. The point of a headless CMS is not that you don't need a head, but actually you can have multiple heads and change them as and when you would like to, without the need of reauthoring the content. In essence, the head is the output and body is where the content is stored and authored. So let's see how it functions compared to the traditional CMS. Compared to the traditional CMS, headless is a backend only content management system that acts as a content repository. This means that you will upload your content once, obviously in headless CMS. However, using APIs, you will be able to deliver that content on multiple channels. That could be multiple websites, that could be your social networks, that could be also your mobile apps, and so on. Content in this case is not tied up to the presentation layer, which means you can build your websites and your applications in whichever technologies you'd like to. On the other hand, traditional CMSs are in charge of the overall process. So let's say your Kentico or Bracco CMS you'll use to create content, to manage workflows and publish content on your pages. In this case, content is tied up to a single output and unfortunately is not reusable. The point of a headless CMS is in the flexibility of choosing heads or technologies that will output your content. Content authors still have an interface and database where they store their content. However, there is no web app or pages. It's just raw content that's coming out of your headless CMS. In reality, you may want to choose to have some content for voice assistants, e-commerce systems, or maybe mobile apps. So the whole idea of headless is for you to be able to have as many heads or technologies as you would like to. And this approach is tailored in such a way that it supports any upcoming technologies. To sum up, here are some of the advantages of headless approach. All content in one place and is ready for omnichannel output. Reusable content, authorizing your content just once, much faster than traditional CMS, and very secure. And finally, a possibility to connect with a lot of different systems. The question is, should you adopt headless or stick with a traditional CMS? As a digital agency, we feel that headless is the right way to go. It's much easier to manage content, way more efficient, and it's secure more than any traditional CMS. Companies that spend a lot of time publishing their content and also working on their content should definitely consider headless CMS. Furthermore, content is stored in one place and you have more control over it. This was a quick intro about headless, and hopefully after this video you have a better idea about headless and how you could potentially benefit of it. If you've still got some questions or uncertainties, feel free to drop me a message.